Hello everybody, Scott Golden here with the Golden Opportunities Coaching YouTube channel. Welcome to those of you who are new. Welcome back to those of you seasoned veterans of what we do around here. What we do around here is bring about conversations of a psychological, mental health, emotional health paradigm. We do that as often as we can, usually several times per week, and we do that for your listening pleasure. We continue to add over 1,400 of these at this point. This is our Life Lessons Series number 263. Life Lessons Series is just something that I've done over the past few years, just try to make life a little easier for people. Life can be complicated, and people make it more complicated than it needs to be sometimes, and sometimes small reminders, just for a few minutes, can be useful in a lot of ways. So, if you are looking for life, relationship, business coaching, or anything in between, would love to be of assistance to you in that way, make something in a good way for you at PO Perception or in the About Me section of this YouTube page are the two ways you can make contact to make something good happen in that direction. So, first thing is, find joy in all things. Look, life is only as serious or as impactful or as stressful as we make it. And so, finding daily joy, finding things to be excited about or interested in or kind of jazzed up about, finding things to make matter is our own responsibility. There are 7 billion people on the planet. There are literally millions, if not billions, of jobs that people can do. There are numerous ways to feel and things to focus on. And so your quality of life is directly related to your quality of focus. And so if you are not getting to a place where you like what's happening in your daily life, then chances are, at least at some level, your focus is off kilter for what you truly want. And that can be something to consider when trying to make longer connections for the future. And it doesn't necessarily mean that we are always going to get what we want, what we need, or where we want to go. But at the end of the day, you've got to make a decision. What are you focused on? Are you focused on joy or are you focused on misery? Because whatever you focus on will multiply and amplify. And kind of making an action plan is super important when it comes to getting more out of your daily life. The next thing is reinvent yourself. Look, who you were, who you are, and who you're becoming are three different points of who you or the identity that you are holding on to. And so finding what's at your root, the things you want to accomplish, finding a compelling why behind the things you're trying to do, but also finding what it is that you need and where it is you want to go and what matters most to you is important. It doesn't necessarily mean that you can't find something better or different or more focused for yourself, but at the end of the day, you also have to understand, no one is going to do the work for you. And so finding a way to do the work and make sure that you are getting the most out of your life to the best of your ability on a consistent basis is yours. You got to carry that. You got to figure that out. Because when you don't, you'll look back at your life as an older person, or even if there's an unexpected health crisis and things will fall out and be a waste of time or kind of not pay off in the way that you intend. And so it's important to begin to understand the value of knowing what it is that you're trying to accomplish and the why and the how and all of that stuff. So the next thing there is to look at things from a deeper level and kind of look at, you know, how are you loving yourself and others? Self-love is important. It's an overstated concept in a lot of circles for self-improvement, but at the same time, loving yourself is acknowledging both your strengths and your weaknesses, identifying the things that make you feel powerful and powerless, getting rid of the things that make you feel powerless to the best of your ability. Obviously, there are situations where we don't necessarily feel we have a solution, but literally, again, there are millions of solutions to any challenge that are out there. If your life isn't changing, it's because you're not taking the correct actions or the right actions or the things that are going to lead you to where you want to be. And so if you don't like where you are, change your actions. Also, giving love and showing gratitude and showing kindness to others needs to become or can become the most central aspect to what you're focused upon. And it doesn't necessarily mean that you have to get walked all over. Obviously, invest at the level that you believe people are investing in you. Don't overgive to the point where you're burnt out, but at the same time, identify ways that you can make the world a better place for yourself on a day-to-day basis, but also understand that you can't necessarily expect other people to solve whatever challenges are in front of you. your accountability to yourself is also important in that process. So until next time, keep your feet on the ground, your mind in the moment. Until next time, everybody.